Okay, once you sign up for online personal training, you'll receive an email that asks you to set up your account. Click the link, set up your password. And then you fill your profile with some basic information. Next, you'll be asked questions about your goals and your exercise history. And we also ask about your schedule and what equipment you have available. All of this helps us create your workouts. And that's it. Click to save your responses. And next, we'll show you how to use the app. Once you've downloaded the app, click on the Trainerize icon. The first time you pull it up, you'll have to sign in. It'll ask you for a profile photo, or you can skip it. And the first time you sign in, it'll take you through some basic functions. The first thing you'll see is your calendar highlighted at the top. As you'll notice, the only thing you have in your calendar is the weight that you just entered. If you slide over to plans, there is not one because we have not created one for you yet. Then if you scroll over to summary, you'll see a summary of all your completed workouts, which again, there are none because you just created your account. So there will be your completed workouts, the number of cardio sessions, your current weight, and a spot to add progress photos. So let's say you want to enter your weight and some body measurements. Click where it says current weight. Click edit. Here's the weight we just entered. You can change that if you'd like. Below that, you can enter your body circumference measurements. And there's a spot for resting heart rate and blood pressure. Click save. Now you can scroll down to body mass index. If you click it, it'll pull up a graph. Here you can chart your results of your BMI, lean body mass, fat mass, circumference measurements, anything you want. And right now it's not much of a graph because we only have one data point. Okay, so by now you've created your account and we've had a chance to create your program. If you slide over to plans, you can notice your training plan. It says building your foundation, 4 weeks. Under that is the workouts that you'll find in your plan. Then if you slide over to the calendar, you'll see that on today, Sunday, is your first workout. So go ahead and click on your first workout. It'll pull it up. At the top will be a workout summary or instructions. Below that are the exercises. From here, you can either click check in just to say that you did the workout, or you could press track, and track will allow you to enter the amount of weight, the repetitions, and any other information on your workout. So here's where you would enter the number of repetitions. So the first exercise is the TRX squat. It says 2 sets of 10. You can fill out your workout as you go. Okay, you get the cable rows. You'll see a spot for the weight. Let's say you do 70 pounds. Enter 70. How many repetitions? 10. If you need to see an exercise, click the three dots to the right. And that pulls up the exercise page. There'll be a video at the top. You can click the video. This will show you the demonstrations from our YouTube channel right inside your app. And once you've seen all you need, you can back out of that. Go back to your log.
Once you've finished your workout, if there are any notes you'd like to add, just click the note icon at the top. Type in whatever you want, click save. And then click end to save. Get your gold star, you can share it to Facebook, and you're done. So by now you've been working out for a couple months and you have a lot more of stats to see. Let's go back down to your current weight. So we're back to your body stats. Tap a measurement to graph it. We'll click on 170 pounds. This pulls up your body weight chart. The graph shows you've lost 10 pounds. And again, you can do this for any measurement that you wish. We'll close out of that. We'll go over to plans. So this pulls up your training plan again. You'll see all the workouts included. We'll slide over to calendar. And we'll see that today is squat day. So you click on this to check in. Press track to record your workout. Now you can see over to the right is a list of the weights and repetitions that you used for the back squat in your last workout. If you need more information, click the three dots. Here you'll see the workout video at the top of the page. Below that is your personal best. And then below that you have more detailed information every time you've done a back squat in one of your workouts. The date, the weight, the number of reps. Okay, so now you're working out. You enter the weight and repetitions for every set. Now let's say you want to do one more set. Just click Add New Set. Type in your weight, repetitions. Once you're finished, click Done, click End. Then you get a high five, you got a new personal best. The 210 pounds you lifted today was 5 more pounds than your previous best. And the total volume, which is the weight multiplied by the repetitions of all the sets. Now the latest feature on this app is its interval workout. So say it's Tuesday and we're due for a circuit workout. Click on the circuit workout. Click track. Okay, now once you're ready to begin, click start workout. It'll give you a 3-2-1 and take you through the exercises and provide an interval timer for you.
Rocking lunge.
So at the top of the timer, it gives you the video description, your countdown timer, the exercise coming up next, and some controls at the bottom to stop or pause your workout. Okay, we'll speed through this. Let's say you want to view the exercise. If you click on the video during the interval, you can watch the video and it won't affect the interval timer. So you can watch it, click done, and the timer's still running. Okay, then once you complete the workout, you can either add stats or click end workout. We'll end the workout. And there's your ending message. Now, if there's any comments or questions you have about the workout, you can click on your trainer's picture at the bottom left of the screen. It'll pull up a conversation bubble. Click on that, enter your message. Click send, and you're done. So let's say you want to add a workout that was not scheduled by your trainer. Slide over to calendar. You'll see that today is Wednesday. You have no workout scheduled. So go ahead and click on the plus at the bottom right of your screen. Here you can add a bunch of things. We're going to click workout. And there are the workouts in the training program to choose from. And we're going to click first workout. So there it is onto the schedule. Tap to check in. Okay, there it is. Click track. Okay, now let's say you want to change it up a little bit. Instead of a TRX squat, you want to do bodyweight squats, or you want to do barbell squats. So click the three dots, hit substitute. You'll see a search bar. You can type whatever exercise you want to sub in. So we'll type barbell squats. And there it is, barbell back squat. Check that, click substitute, and it replaces TRX squat in your workout. Okay, and let's say we want to change the modified push-ups as well. Same thing, click the dots, hit substitute, search for bench press. You'll see a bunch of options. Let's say we want to do a machine bench press today. So we'll click that, and it gets entered in. One more feature real quick. Let's say you're doing your workout and you want to time your rest between sets. There's a stopwatch at the bottom right. You can click on that and it'll pull up your rest timer. Its default is 1 minute, but you can change that by clicking the settings at the top right. And finally, we'll go over how to sync up your MyFitnessPal account. Click the three bars at the top left, go into Settings, scroll down to MyFitnessPal. Click Connect, log in. Click Authorize, and you're done. So now when you go back to your summary page, it'll include the data imported from your MyFitnessPal account. That'll be your total calories eaten and your daily macros, the percentages of your protein, fat, and carbohydrates. And then if you slide over to calendar, you'll notice that in addition to your workouts and your body measurements, you'll also have a summary of your nutrition for the day. If you click on one of the days, you get some more information. And here you have a bigger graph of your macros. And if you have any goals set, it'll show them here as well.